Hello, my name is Antonio Ballerina. I'm the president of an umbrella federation that groups the associations of Italian people coming from Istria, Fiume, Dalmatia, and that suffered the ethnic cleansing operated by the Tito's communist regime during the World War II. These people populated for the 85-90% the region, the eastern border of the Adriatic Sea. They were swept away during the war after the persecution of the regime that was a kind of umbrella to the anti-Italian nationalism. I was born in a refugee camp here in Rome, and we are still fighting over 70 years. For our human rights denied. Our people are different social census. Many of those probably you know, like Mario Andretti or Lidia Bastianich or Ottavio Missoni, that was part of this land, that was part of these people. And the persecution of these people was very violent. Many thousands of them were killed. Thrown them into a vertical cave, which name is Foiba, and as I already told, 90%, 85% of the population went away from their land. The movie Red Land is the first movie that described this story. We didn't have the possibility to do that until now, and it's an opportunity, a wonderful opportunity for us. To show what happened in this land to the rest of the world, and also to we would like the people that take care of the human rights can understand our human rights denied until now.
Sono stati realizzati molti film sul secondo conflitto mondiale. Ci si chiede ancora perché si debba ritornare su quel periodo dopo che si è già detto molto. Ma credo che questo non sia vero. Senza avere il coraggio di esternare ciò che la storia realmente desidera dichiarare a chiunque. Una storia simbolo del martirio del popolo istriano, giuliano e dalmata. Norma Cossetto. Un esempio, un simbolo di altre molte infinite silenziose sofferenze che sicuramente saranno celate a vita. Questa non è una storia di parte, non ha un colore politico, ha solo il desiderio di raccontare che il colore delle anime delle persone sono tutte uguali
e che a nessuna di esse dovrà mai essere annientato il pensiero, la speranza, un qualsiasi ideale, il credo verso Dio.